And welcome back. So what does it feel like to perform at the McCallum Theater and before the hometown crowd? Travis Nesbitt gets to do this on Monday. Travis grew up in the Inland Empire, and he's one of the stars of Bravo Amici. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you for having me.
We're talking about, are you nervous when you know that you're going to have friends out in the audience?
Thank you for saying that. Now I am. Yeah.
Oh.
No, no, no. I mean, like we were saying before, that, you know, you always have to expect people to want you to succeed.
Yeah,
you know,
it's such absolutely.
Performing is a mental game as well as like an artistic endeavor as well.
But you got your start here.
I did. Yeah.
Peter Pan.
Peter Pan, I did, oh my gosh, this was like almost 20 years ago, which I cannot believe. I still come here and I feel like I'm 16 again.
That's good.
Yeah, so I did Huck in Big River, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. I played Peter in Peter Pan. I was one of the first males to play
right,
that part.
Yeah.
And then I did Joseph in Joseph the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
So you act and you sing. What do you like better?
Oh my gosh, I think, you know, you can't like one more than the other, because they're both part of it, you know, especially if you're going to call yourself a musical theater performer. It's both. And so you have to do it simultaneously.
All right, so how do you go from doing Peter Pan at 16, 17 years old to now touring the country and to other countries as well? How do you get from there to there?
Well, you know, I have the McCallum Theater really to thank, because, you know, when I was 16 years old, and, you know, you're just starting to figure out what you want to do for the rest of your life. And I had a friend, Karen Schultz from Onstage Theater Company, which was the theater company out here, took a chance on me. And I remember standing on the McCallum stage thinking, this is incredible. This is an incredible theater. I feel like I have something to offer these audiences, and I want to do this for the rest of my life. And it was like, because I got that opportunity here in Palm Springs, it changed my life. And I forever have, you know, this very nostalgic feeling for the community here.
So what was the light bulb moment when you're on that stage, or any stage, and you realize, you know, I'm pretty good at this. I could do this for a living.
I mean, you know, I think it was obviously feedback. People were telling me, wow, you're really good at this. You're going to go to college for this, right? And I was like, no, I want to make a lot of money.
Yeah.
that was the turning point right there.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think the feeling of being on that stage, and there was a moment in Big River when I finished this show all by myself on the stage, just thinking, wow, this is just so incredible and so kinetic, and I couldn't possibly do anything else for the rest of my life.
So come Monday, you're going to walk out on that stage with a few other people in the show.
Four other very talented people.
Yeah. And what's the show about?
So it's an opera crossover group, which was a genre that really became popular in the early 2000s. And this group, Amici Forever, which predates Bravo Amici, really started it and coined the term. And then people started to run with it as well. And so this is kind of a revival of that first group. And we're taking all of the songs, plus some Broadway stuff, plus some opera, like Nessun Dorma, which everybody loves. And that's what the show's gonna be. It's a lot of fun, and we connect with the audiences, so they get to know us while we're on stage. And it's not just, you know, a park and bark opera.
Park and
you
bark.
You know, old school performance.
I've not heard that expression.
Oh yeah, that's
it. Well, I'm excited to meet you, and I know people are gonna wanna see somebody they know up on stage there on Monday night at 7 o'clock at the McCallum.
I'm so excited.
All right, continued success.
Thank you so much.
All right, appreciate you being here. We'll take a break, and we'll be right back. Stay with us, please.